All right, question number two from the NAEMSE 2019 symposium in Fort Worth, Texas. After our question yesterday, we went in a little bit different style today, hopefully a little bit less controversial, but still very important nonetheless. So let's look at the question. I'm Dan Limmer from Limmer Education. 58-year-old male complains of abdominal pain. He's had nausea. He's been vomiting. His skin is hot to the touch. He points to his left lower abdominal quadrant when you ask him where it hurts the most. Vital signs, pulse of 94, respiratory to 16, 132 on 88, setting at 97% on room air. You should suspect. Now, I'll give a big picture view of this question first. Sometimes you look at a question and you say, okay, that's the right answer. What I think this question is a good example of is that we probably will rule out three being left with the correct answer. One of the things that are done is the questions usually have, the distractors usually have a certain amount of choosability. So we have to look at the choices, go back to the stem of the question and look at these and say, which one is right? So as we watched people look at this in the booth, they keyed on a couple things. One of them was that the skin was hot to touch, which may indicate an infectious process. And I think that's good thinking, and that rules out a couple things. So in the least chosen, appropriately so at the booth, renal calculi, okay, so some stones and you can have nausea and vomiting and abdominal pain, probably not left lower quadrant, although it can be very overwhelming. That's probably the one that we rule out first. Ulcerative colitis, while we can have some of these signs and symptoms, there's things missing from the stem. Diarrhea, maybe bloody diarrhea, some pus, you know, really things in this. So that's not there either. That leaves us two, diverticulitis and peritonitis. Now in this, diverticulitis was the most chosen and it's correct. In this, we have a patient who is in a lot of discomfort. He seems hemodynamically and generally be okay, and I think the hot skin tends to fit that. Peritonitis, which was the next most chosen, generally would have a little bit more pain and a sicker presentation. Think about peritonitis. What irritates the peritoneum? Is it blood? Is it abdominal? Is it intestinal or stomach contents? Those things not only cause significant pain and really hot and painful, there's often an underlying condition causing that, which makes the patient sick. So if we've ruled out renal calculi, ulcerative colitis, and peritonitis as being probably the sickest of it, which doesn't match this, we're left with diverticulitis, which does match in a majority of these categories and is the best answer for this question. We'll do one more today at NAEMSE in Fort Worth. Again, I'm Dan Limmer from Limmer Education. And as always, we thank you very much for watching.